by Christmas?
圣诞的意义是什么？
Why we gather here today?
我们为什么今天在这里相聚？
Father, help us open our hearts.
亲爱的天父啊，请你打开我们的心。
Help us to understand.
请让我们用心的领受。
Awesome God, what is awesome means?
伟大的神，伟大的意义是什么？
Help us understand a little bit more of Jesus today.
让我们今天能够更深一步的认识耶稣基督。
We pray that you help every one of us.
我们祷告你能够帮助我们在座的每一个人。
In Jesus' name we pray.
以耶稣基督的名求。
Amen.
Amen.
All right, we're going to celebrate Christmas in the next few weeks.
还有几周我们就要庆祝圣诞节了。
Well, let me ask you a question.
那让我来问大家一个问题。
Last week, if you don't remember anything but two words, you should remember.
关于上周，你应该，如果你可能忘记大多数的内容，应该有两个词你应该还记得住。
Or use in English, there's two words.
在用英语来讲呢，还是有两个词。
Well, in Chinese, maybe four words.
在中文来讲呢，可能是四个词。
But anyway, it's just two ideas, right?
但是呢，是有两个概念。
Well, first one is.
那第一个是什么呢
？Truth, right?
是真理。
How about the second one?
第二个是什么？
文化 or culture, for that matter.
是文化。
All right, celebrating Christmas, is that the truth or is a culture?
那庆祝圣诞是一个真理还是一个文化
？OK, you understand what I'm saying?
大家了解我在讲什么吗
right, ？But many people are a little bit confused. All right, let me give you a short review. All right,
让我们来重新的来回顾一下我们上次讲的。
The most important thing in end time as a believer.
作为一个有信仰的人，我们最重要的是什么
？A very, very critical task.
是非常重要的一个任务
is to discern
是分辨
what is truth
什么是真理
what is culture
什么是文化
okay the Bible full of truth
圣经呢是充满了真理
in the same time full of culture
同时呢圣经里边也布满了文化
as a mature believer
作为一个有信仰的多年的人
，We need the methodology, we need the skill set, we need to know how.
我们应该有这个方面的能力，我们应该知道
to discern what is truth and what is culture.
来分辨什么是真理，什么是文化。
The truth in a short verse, in a short sentence.
真理的定义呢
？Is that of God?
这是不是属神的
？Not changeable throughout the ages and times and demograph
是与时间无关的一个
true throughout the human history
真理呢，在整个人类的进程当中
，is all true
它永远都是真理
，is all of God
它永远都是属神的，从神而来的。
On the other hand。
另一方面来讲
When we talk about the culture,
我们可能会讲到文化
It's all human history related.
文化呢是跟人的历史相关的
It's accumulation of your thinking and my thinking.
是我们的所思所想的一个积累
Our habits, our customs and everything else.
是我们的文化是我们的习惯的一个积累
There's a lot of truth in culture, yes.
在文化当中有很多的真理
Well, this, I don't know what I could say vice versa, but let's forget about that one. But we need to discern. That's the key.
我们必须来分辨什么是真理，什么是文化。
There is a good culture and there is a bad culture.
在文化是分好坏的。
And depends on the time, depends on the ages.
文化的好坏取决于所在的时代性和区域性。
So there's a relativity in culture in that sense.
所以呢，在文化当中呢，是有一个相对的一个概念。
In the 16th or in the 15th or in a very very early stage, slavery is common. It's a culture at that time.
可能在十五六世纪或者更早之前的时候，奴隶是一个非常普遍的一个情况，所以在当时的文化是当时的一个文化。
But nowadays, it's not acceptable.
但是在现在呢，当今呢是无法让我们是无法 一个接受的一个东西。
Culture varies.
所以说文化是变化的一个东西。
According to the time and geography and everything else, it changes.
它是一个随着时间和区域而变化的。
But the truth never change.
但是真理无论在哪里它都是永远是一样的。
Because it belongs to God, transcend time and a space and everything else.
所以它是因为真理是源于神的，所以它是超越时间和空间的。
So when we read Bible,
所以当我们读圣经的时候，
as a mature believer,
作为一个有信仰的，
we need to discern what is truth and what is culture.
我们需要去分辨什么是真理，什么是文化。
A lot of problem of the church today,
在当今的教会有很多的问题。
Is that we take our culture elevated to a point.That is truth.
在教会当中，我们将有一些文化当成真理来对待。
Not only I want to obey, and I force upon other people, and want everybody obeys because I think this is the truth.
所以当我们把一些文化当成真理来遵循的时候，我们可能会来强迫别人来遵
循。So we understand these two words, right?
所以现在我们了解真理和文化的区别。
Use these two words to go around the world, go around the church.
利用这两个概念呢，我们可以去不同的地方，不同的教会。
We want to remind everyone in the church in particular, understand we need to discern.
我们需要教会的每一个人，不同的教会的每一个人来理解这个不同的概念。
We need to discern, number one.
我们需要明辨分辨。
But no judge.
但是我们不要去
论断。Embrace one another in particular in culture.
让我们来这个
彼此包容。
彼此包容。
Okay, let me ask you this then. Celebrating Christmas is a culture or it's a truth?
那我来问大家一个问题呢，庆祝圣诞是一个真理还是一
个文化？ What
do you think?
It's a what? It's a culture, yes.
是一个文化。
Some churches celebrate.
有些教会呢是来做这个庆祝
活动。And some churches do not.
那有些教会
celebrate.
并不庆祝。
And some churches even emphasize we shouldn't be celebrating because this is not told in the Bible.
有些教会呢，甚至他强调他们会强调说他们不会去庆祝圣诞，因为这个庆祝活动在圣经当中没有出现。
Celebrating Christmas is pure culture.
所以庆祝圣诞是纯粹的一个文化意义的一个活动。
And as church to celebrate, and some churches doesn't celebrate.It doesn't really matter.
所以有些教会你无论你庆祝与否都并不重要。
The important thing is if you understand or if you know the Christ, the Jesus, what we're celebrating.
但最重要的是我们要知道我们庆祝的是庆祝谁，是庆祝耶稣基督。
So I remember a long time ago, I was struggling about it. And you know, shall we celebrate Christmas?
我有一段时间呢，我自己也很困惑，我们是否应该庆祝圣诞。
And then I heard one minister told me.
所以我听到一个牧师告诉我。
He says, you know, it doesn't really matter you want to celebrate or not, how, do it Christmas Eve, Carolyn, it really doesn't matter.
他告诉我呢，其实并不重要，我们是否来庆祝圣诞，庆祝这个平安夜。
Why don't we use this occasion?
那我们为什么会利用这个节日呢？
为什么不利用？
不利用这个节日。
Why don't we use this occasion to let everyone know who Christ is?
为什么我们不利用这个节日，让更多的人来知道谁是基督
？We don't want to bother by the legalist stuff.
我们并不想来，然后被这个概念所困惑。
Why don't we use this time of the year to tell everyone who Jesus is?
我们应该利用这个机会来告诉每个人谁是耶稣基督。
So from now on,
所以从现在开始
，if you go to any churches around the world,
如果你去其他的教会
，if some churches celebrate, great, you celebrate with them.
如果有些教会他们庆祝，那很好，你跟他们一同庆祝。
If some church don't celebrate, just don't celebrate. That's all.
如果有些教会他们并不庆祝，那也没有关系。
But the point is, we need to understand who Jesus is.
但重要的是，我们要知道耶稣是谁。
So we use this occasion.
所以我们来利用这个节日。
I count this three Sundays.
我要用三周的时间。
Before Christmas,
在圣诞节之前。
I like to share who Jesus is.
我愿意跟大家分享谁是耶稣。
So today is the first time I share with you who who is Jesus.
今天呢是第一堂课。
You know, I believe in Christ, yeah, many years, over half a century, probably.
我信仰耶稣基督已经有超过五十年了。
I thought sometimes I already know who Jesus is.
很多时候我想我觉得我认识耶稣。
But you know what? I found out I am not.
但是你知道吗？其实我觉得我，并非是这样。
因为 ，no. It just, you know, in the past 2 weeks.
但是在过去两周的时间里
，I have some new revelation.
我有一些新的启示。
Christ is something new again.
耶稣呢，对我是一个又是一个很崭新的一个形象。
It kind of shocked me.
然后让我感到震惊惊喜。
I have to humble myself.
我需要来谦卑我自己。
You and I think we know who Jesus is. Is that right?
你可能会跟我一样，我们在觉得我们知道谁是耶稣。
But the way we understand, comprehend it is very, very limited.
但是我们的认识是非常非常有限的。
So I'd like to share with you what I have been inspired in the last 2 weeks.
所以呢，我愿意跟大家分享我过去两周所领受的一些东西。
While this passage came to my mind,
这节经文呢，到了我的脑海里。
Okay, let's all read out.
让我们一起来阅读。
If you don't have a good eyesight, you can look at the bulletin.
大家的那个周报上面也有这段经文，如果你也可以
单阅读。No one has excuses not to read, okay?
所以我们都可以一起来读。
All right, 1, 2, 3. For to which of the angels did God ever say, You are my son, today I fathered you. In another place he says, I will be his father, and he will be my son.We all know God the Father, God the Son, you know, God the Holy Spirit.
我们都知道，天父、圣子、圣灵。
And I'm impressed and I was shocked by the new or the impressed, inspiration God has put in my heart.
我知道神在我心中所放的这些概念真理。
He's God's Son.
是神的儿子。
So, it's God's son.
是神的儿子。
And I have a new layer of understanding.
所以我有一个新的理解。
The father here is a verb, right?
这里边的父是一个动词。
Okay, fathered. Fathered.
是中文翻译为今日生你。
Or beget or begot.
是为父
Father God begot Jesus Christ.
是天父生了耶稣基督。所以呢
God did not create Jesus Christ.
所以神并没有创造耶稣基督。
God begot.Christ Jesus.
耶稣基督是成为天父成为耶稣基督的父。
The contrast of fathered and created to me has a new layer of meaning.
上帝跟创造物是不同的。
In this passage, it only speaks of one thing.
在这里边只讲了一件事情。
Angels are created.
天使是被创造是创造物。
For that matter, you and I also been created.
你和我呢？我们也都是创造物。
We are creation.
我们是被创造的。
Jesus is not.
耶稣基督不是
created.
耶稣基督不是被创造的。
Fathered Christ.
天父作为耶稣基督的父，成为耶稣基督的父。
Allow me use an analogy.
请让我做一个比喻。
A little bit similar, but there's many folds meaning into it.
有一点点相似。
But please do not read too much of it, okay?
但是也有很多的不同。
You know how in the Garden of Eden?
Eden?
Eden.
你知道 伊甸园吗？
When God created man, right?
当神创造了一个人。
Well, how did woman come about?
女人是怎么样出来的？怎么样出场的？
Very good, 出场。Very good, very good translation. God used one of the man's rib, right?
神用了男人的一个肋骨。
He pulled out his rib. I don't know, pull or not, I don't know. But anyway, he used one of his rib, man's rib.
他用了男人的一个肋骨。
Form a woman.
然后变成了一个女人。
Man and woman.Basically, a woman is come from a man.
所以女人是从男人而来的。
They are equally important, valued.
所以他们两个是平等的，是相同重要的。
But there's an order. Men are first, and women are second.
但这有一个顺序，是男人在前，女人在后。
I found very similarly, God fathered Christ.
所以我觉得有点跟天父和圣子为有点相似。
Man and woman, husband and wife, they should unite as one.
所以男人和女人，丈夫妻子应该成为合为一体。
The same way as the father and the son are one.
这同样的概念就是在天父和圣子他们也是一体的。
In my opinion,
我认为。
In my humble opinion.
我谦卑地认为
God used a relationship of a husband and a wife.
我认为呢，上帝呢用丈夫和妻子这个概念
give us a little bit hint, a taste how triune God is like.
这作为一个预表，作为一个我们来感受、来理解天父和圣子的关系。
Lord Yahweh fathered.Christ Jesus.
我们的天父耶和华他为父成为耶稣基督的父。
Because he fathered Christ.
因为他成为耶稣基督的父。
Everything he has, Christ has.
所以他所有的耶稣基督也拥有。
Because Father is 100% just and 100% love.
因为天父呢是100%的公义，100%的充满了爱。
The Son is also 100% loving and just.
所以圣子呢也是完全的公义和充满了爱。
Fathered.
所以说是今日生你是为父。
When you and I are created.
当你和我们被造的时候。
We are creation.
我们是被造物。
We are not perfect.
我们并不完美。
God fathered Christ.
天父作为耶稣基督成父
fathered perfect
是完美的神完美的天父他生了完美的圣子
We are creation, it's good
我们作为被造物我们是好的、okay? 但我们并不完美
So many many theology come into play I say, thank you God
所以在这里边有很多神学的问题在里边
And all put together in aBeautiful big picture. It all makes sense.
所有这一切成为一个很美好的一个画卷。
In the infinite wisdom of God.
作为充满无限的、充满无限智慧的神。
There is no time in God's realm.
在神那里是没有时间的限制。
God created a timeline.
神创造了这个时间。创造了时间线。
He says, I fathered you today. This today is not on the timeline, as you and I may think.
所以他在这里说，我今日生你的这个今日，并不是一个点，一个我们理解的一个时间的点。
In the infinite God,
在无限当中
fathered his son.
在用无限智慧能力的神，他创造他。生了耶稣基督。
The very important concept today, you and I need to remember throughout our life.
这是一个非常重要的概念，我们在我们生命当中需要谨记。
Christ is not created.
我们要知道，耶稣基督并不是被造的。
He is not an angel.
他不是天使。
He is not a creation.
他不是被造物。
Father God fathered the Son.
天父上帝他生了耶稣基督，成为耶稣基督的父。
From other passage in the Bible,
从圣经中其他的经文来讲，
we know Christ is the only begotten Son.
我们知道耶稣基督是天父唯一的儿子。
So Father has fathered the Christ.
所以天父生了耶稣基督。
Three Godheads are one God.
所以三位一体，我们只有一个神。
God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
有天父、圣子、圣灵。
Why they only one God?
为什么这儿只有一个神？
Because they are one, they are totally united.
因为只有一个神，因为他们是完全的合而为一的。
They are three Godheads,
有
but only one God.
有三个位格，但只有一个神。
Because they are in total unity.
因为他们完全的合一。
You and I could never understand all the details or the concepts. We cannot.
我们作为被造，我们永远无法知道每一个细节。
Simply because we are not God.
因为很简单，因为我们并不是神。
We are categorically different. We are mere creation.
我们跟他的位格完全不一样，我们是 只仅仅是被造物。
God is a creator.
神他是一个创造天地的神。
We never understand our creator.
我们永远没法理解我们神。
God has revealed what he can, what we can understand.
上帝向我们显现了我们能理解的部分。
And he told us twice, my son, Jesus Christ, is fathered through me.
他通过两个地方来说，我的儿子耶稣基督是通过我而生。
One and only begotten Son.
是唯一的神，唯一的神的儿子。
And this is the reason we need to believe in Christ.
这是我们需要相信耶稣基督的原因。
Many of us have the question.
我们很多有一个问题。
I believe in God.
我相信神。
But I don't believe in Jesus.
但我并不相信耶稣。
I'm sorry to say.
我非常抱歉的来跟你讲。
Your only way you to understand believing God is to believe in through Jesus.
你唯一的途径可以理解神，就是只有通过耶稣基督。
If there's no other way has been given in the world that we can understand the God.
因为在这世上我们没有别的方法可以更深的理解神。
In the Old Testament, also give us the same line.
在旧约当中也有相同的类似的经文。
And this is I is the from the speaking, is the anointed one, Jesus Christ.
这个我就是说被受膏的，就是耶稣基督。
All right, and this is He is speaking.
就是他在说话。
All right, okay. Now let's read out this one. Okay.
让我们一起来读这段经文。
One, two, three. I will proclaim the decree of the Lord. He said to me, "You are my son. Today I have begotten you."
我今日生你。
LORD, all capital, this word.
你看到这个主是大，在英文当中是大写的。
You pronounce Yahweh.
你可以来读成耶和华。
Yes, he said to me, that's Yahweh the Father said.
就是在这里是主耶和华说。
Telling Jesus, you are my son.
他告诉耶稣说你是我的儿子。
Again, today,
而且他还说了今天。
I have begotten you.
我生了你。
So, Father the Son, I mean Father, Father, Holy Father, begot the Christ, the Holy Son.
在这里讲呢，神生了他儿子耶稣。
I think a father-son relationship is also what has demonstrated.Help us understand what's the relationship between them.
这里讲了父子的关系用父子关系 来描述他们俩的关系。
So whenever people have questions, who is triune God? How come three Godheads and only you claim only one God?
当很多人来问这个问题说为什么神有三个位格。
Yes, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
天父、圣子、圣灵。
They are one God.
这有只有一位神。
Because they are total unity.
因为他们是完全的合一的。
Just like in a family on earth.
只是完全就像我们在地球在我们是
Nobody else in this world has a relationship stronger than a husband and a wife.
在这个世上没有比丈夫和妻子更紧密的关系。
Because they are united together.
因为他们是合二为一
的。One become one.
因为他们成为一体。
No relationship on earth has such a relationship.
在其他的关系与夫妻关系来比，都不如夫妻关系来的亲密。
And I believe it's a little bit analogy help us to understand what's the relationship between the three Godheads.
我相信呢，我们夫妻的关系是一个预表，是一个让我们可以理解天父和圣子的关系的一个途径。
So let me put a small summary.
我来总结一下。
What do you mean by Son of God?
神的儿子的意思是什么
？God has only one begotten Son.
神只生了一个儿子。
And that just Jesus Christ.
那就是耶稣基督。
No one in this world dare to say that I'm Son of God and proven so.
没有人敢说他是神的儿子。
When Jesus says, "Once you know me, you know the Father."
当基督说你认识了我，你就认识了天父。
There's no other path you can know God but through me.
叫没有其他的位，没有其他的方法，你可以认识神，只有通过我。
Lord Yahweh begot, not created Jesus Christ.
他生了耶稣基督，但他。并没有创造耶稣基督。
We have to have this. We should grab this. This is our faith, the foundation of our faith.
这是我们信仰的基石。
Not believing God, not just believing God.
不只是相信神。
But believing Jesus, that's the matter.
我们要相信基督耶稣。
A couple, 10 minutes ago, 15 minutes ago, we sang a song.
之前呢，我们刚开始的时候，我们唱了一首歌。
Christ is the center of the world.
耶稣是世界的中心。
And Christ is the center of the whole universe.
耶稣是整个宇宙的中心。
Christ is the meaning of the whole human history.
耶稣是我们人类的人类生存的意义。
We came from him.
我们从他而来。
And one day we'll go back to him.
有一天呢，我们会到他那里而去。
He's the only channel.
他是我们唯一的渠道。
We have everything. He is the final decision maker.
我们有很多事情，但他是唯一掌权的人。
No one else have that kind of a God's ability to say, "I'm son of God and I have the final say."
没有人可以说他是神的儿子，他有这样的权柄。
But Christ said himself and proven so.
但是耶稣基督他这么说，而且他也证明了他是这样的能力。
So very important.
非常重要的是
Yahweh begot Christ.
非常重要的是耶和华他生了耶稣基督。
He fathered Jesus.
他成为耶稣基督的父。
Not created.
他并没有创造耶稣基督。
Secondly,
第二个
they are totally united as one.
他们是完全合而为一的。
This is a demonstration how we people, how we are not just a husband and wife.And also, churches, we need to be united.
这也预表了，也启示我们不只是夫妻之间，而且是不同的教会之间，我们需要合而为一。
How can we be one?
我们如何怎么样能够合而为一呢
？In terms of the truth or in terms of the culture?
我们是应该根据真理，还是应该依靠文化
？We are one because of the truth has only one. That's God Himself.
我们合一是因为真理。
Diversity, variety of culture, everybody is different.
在文化来讲，从个体来讲，每个人每个文化都是不相同的。
God enjoys variety.
但神是非常喜悦多样性。
God appreciates diversity.
神是非常的喜欢。
But among all these varieties, but we need to be united, one.
但是我们有不同的，我们有区别，我们有多样性，但是我们要合而为一。
Only united.In truth, and that's only required.
我们在真理中合而为一。
Because Christ was one with Father.
因为神和他的儿子是一体的，合一的。
In the book of John, he says, "I was one with Father."
因为在圣经当中讲，我与父合为一。
We are originally just one. We're all together all this time.
我们始终在一起，我们始终为一的。
So when Christ When Christ died on the cross,
所以当基督在十架上死的时候
，He was separated from the Father.
他与神隔绝。
He was so much suffering beyond our comprehension.
他承受了很多的苦难。
It is because God was one and Christ was with Father all this time.
这是因为他们是合二为一的，耶稣与神始终一起。
The whole book of Gospel of John.
整个约翰福音当中。
He only stated, I said, have one statement.
有一个非常重要的主旨。
At the very end.
在这个书的整个结尾的部分。
In the chapter 20.
在二十章的时候。
And he says.
他说。
But all these things recorded so that you may believe that Jesus is Christ, the Son of God.
这里边讲。但记这些事，要叫你们信耶稣是基督，是神的儿子。
While in the beginning, in the Old Testament time,
在旧约时代的，在最初的时候，起初的时候
，this revelation wasn't clear at all.
在这个启示并不是很清晰。
Everybody think, oh, there's only one God.
很多人都在想，哦，这当时只有一个神。
How you, Jesus, dare to claim you are Son of God? There won't be two gods, isn't that right?
你耶稣怎么样可以说你是神的儿子？这没有第二个神。
Because they don't understand what unity means.
因为他们不了解合一是什么意思。
So, John wrote this book.
所以约翰他写了这本书。
In his old age.
在他很年老的时候，年长的时候。
Think about this is close to the end of the first century.
你可以想这是在第一世纪、一世纪的结尾的时候。
I believe this is one of the few last books recorded as in Bible.
我相信这是圣经当中可能比较晚的一本书，非常晚的一本书。
And this is the last book of gospel among the four gospels. This John is the last one.
在四个福音书当中，约翰福音也应该是最晚一本成书的。
He emphasized and he brought up this subject.
他强调了他这个主题。
Yes, yeah. Jesus was son of man and he's a servant and and Jews kings and so forth.
他强调了耶稣是神的儿子，他强调了很多的重要的概念。
But at the very end,
但是在最终的时候
，he put out this statement.
他讲了这句话。
So the book of John is to help you understand he is the Son of God.
所以约翰福音的主旨呢，就是来让我们来理解他耶稣呢是神的儿子。
So sounds very easy, Son of God.
所以说我们听起来好像很简单。
But to me, have a new layer of understanding.
但是对我来说是有一个新的一个层次的理解。
Father begot.Jesus Christ.
天父成为了耶稣的，是生了耶稣基督。
Same value, same essence, like the Father.
基督是与神的，与天父的重要性是一样的。
Therefore, I believe there's order in three Godheads.
所以我相信，我相信这个顺序。
More so emphasized to my understanding.
对我的理解来说
，Father is always the first，
天父永远是第一位的
，and followed by the Son，
然后是他的儿子
，and the Holy Spirit， and that's the Spirit of Jesus，
然后是圣灵，是耶稣基督的圣灵。
So we as we approach, we understand God the Father。
当我们了解天父
，we。Can only understand know God through Christ Himself.
我们无法了解天父，如果我们不通过耶稣基督的话。
The order is also very important.
这个次序也是非常的重要。
Father come first.
天父第一。
And the Son always obey His Father.
圣子永远都是听从他的天父。
Just like a husband and wife.
就像夫妻一样。
They are the same value before God.
他们在神面前是相同重要的。
Women are equally important and valuable, just like men.
女性和男性是有同样的相同的重要性在神面前。
But there's order.
但是这有一个次序。
The husband is the head of the household.
丈夫呢是一家之主。
The wife submit to her husband.
妻子呢顺从她的
丈
夫。
Not because she is inferior.
并不是因为这个女性她对她丈夫的害怕的原因。
There's an order.
因为这是有个次序。
The order is for protection.
这个先后的次序是为了保护我们。
Okay, this is another sermon I'm not going to preach. But order we need to respect is for protection of the wives.
这个次序我们要尊重，遵守这个次序是为了保护女性，保护妻子。
All ladies, all sisters,
所有女性，所有的姊妹们。
Think about, you are just like Christ in three, a triune God.
你可以把你们想象成为在三位一体当中神的儿子的地位。
You are equally the same as the father as your husband.
你是 与你的丈夫是同等重要的，地位相同的。
Only the order is different, just like Christ submissive to his father.
唯一的区别就是次序，就像天父和圣子的区别。
Everything makes sense.
所有一切都顺理成章。
I thank God.
我感谢神。
Sounds easy.
听起来很简单
，but it all applicable in our lives.
但所有一切我们都可以，都是可以运用到我们的生命当中。
So in Christmas time,
所以在圣诞节的这个季节
，What are we celebrating?
我们庆祝什么
？Celebrating the birth of His Son.
我们来庆祝他神的儿子的诞生。
Because of His Son,
因为他的儿子。
Because of what Jesus has done,
因为耶稣基督所做的。
Now we know God.
所以呢，我们可以了解神。
And we are sure we also know Father.
我们确定，我们同样也认识天父。
Because they are the same in many sense.
因为他们在很多方面，他们是一样的。
I thank God.
我感谢神。
Let's all pray.
让我们一起来祷告。
Father, I thank you.
天父，我感谢你。
You begot Jesus.
你生了耶稣基督。
You didn't create him.
你并没有创造他。
You father the Christ.
你生了耶稣基督，你成为耶稣基督的父。
The same essence.
就好像。
The same quality in everything else, just like you, the father.
所有的他们都是一样的，他耶稣与你完全一样，就像天父一样。
And you send him down onto earth.
你把他派到人间。
Of course, Christ is totally willing and able. He died on the cross for my sin, for everyone's sin.
耶稣基督他凭着自己全心愿意为我们牺牲舍弃他的生命。
We thank you for this triune God.
我们感谢这个三位一体。
We see the Father.
我们看到天父。
We see the Holy Son.
我们看到圣子。
And we also see the Spirit of the Son.
我们同时看到了圣子的灵，圣灵。
And Father, we thank you.
天父，我们感谢你。
We thank you.
我们感谢你。
In Jesus' name we pray.
我们祷告以耶稣基督的名。
Amen.
Amen.